टुडे ब्राइट एंड अर्ली। हाय प्रज्ञा, हाय अमन, हाय गुरु, हाय खुशबू, हाय नीरू, हाय डेविल, हाय अमृता, हाय सलोमी, हाय अभय, हाय ओशन, हाय अमृता, हाय नव्या। गाइस, आई एम नॉट लेट, व्हाट आर यू सेइंग? सो गाइस, समटाइम्स व्हाट हैपेंस इज दैट यू नो इवन व्हेन आई एम लाइव आई डोंट नो इफ आई एम देयर और नॉट, सो आई हैव टू वेट अ लिटिल टू चेक। हाय रमन, हाय रिद्धि, गुड आफ्टरनून, गुड आफ्टरनून। सो हाउ आर यू ऑल डूइंग टुडे? व्हाट्स अप? व्हाट्स न्यू? हाय डेविल, हाय अभिनव, यस ऑफ कोर्स आई रिमेम्बर यू रमन। सो गाइस, द लाइट कीप्स गोइंग ऑफ, सो आई माइट बी इन द डार्क इन बिटवीन, सो आई एम सॉरी फॉर दैट। हाय मलिका, हाय काव्या, हाय जोगेंद्र, हाय वनमई, हाय देवास्मिता, हाय प्रोधन, राइट, हेलो हेलो हेलो। थैंक यू रिद्धि। So guys, welcome to today's class. Today we are going to start with a very very important history chapter of your class 8, from trade to territory, the company establishes power. This is the most important chapter. Actually, it's very important, also very very interesting. This chapter will answer your major question: how did the British come to India as traders, and how eventually they succeeded into becoming this huge territorial power. है ना, इंडिया में तो वो ट्रेडर की तरह आए थे, छोटे छोटे की प्लीज हमें कॉटन दे दो, सिल्क दे दो। देन हाउ डिड दे बिकम, यू नो, हाउ डिड दे कंट्रोल सच अ ह्यूज टेरिटरी? दैट्स व्हाट वी आर गोइंग टू डू इन टुडेस चैप्टर। एंड एट द एंड ऑफ कोर्स मेंटी होगा, ठीक है? वी आर गोइंग टू हैव अ मेंटी एट द एंड ऑफ द सेशन। कैन यू टेल मी? अच्छा, हाय स्निग्धा। ओके, सो गाइस, अगेन आई एम सॉरी इफ यू आर नॉट एबल टू सी मी क्लियरली, द लाइट इज यू नो लाइट्स गॉन, सो I just have a bulb that's brightening my face. Good afternoon. Hi Amrita, hi Shubhi. So guys, show me your attendance right now by giving a like to the video. Give a like to the video to show me that you are attending. Subscribe to the channel if you are new. Give me a heart right now if you are new. If you are seeing me for the very first time. Hi Pradhan, hi Alugu. So guys, I've started remembering your names also. Great. Hi Padhan, hi Ashwini. Aman, you know the answer. It's okay. Still, you can be in the session to revise. Hi Himanshi, good afternoon. Good afternoon. All right. So 150 people watching, but very few likes. Guys, give me a like. Show me your attendance. Attendance abhi isi waqt hoko, so that I know that you're there in the session, right? That you're excited for the session. Now, before I begin, let me tell you what the weekly schedule this week looks like. Today, of course, I'm going to start with your chapter from trade to territory. Very important chapter. The entire week, we are going to continue with this chapter. We are going to, do little parts so that it's not a lot for one day. Tomorrow, 15th June, we are going to do this amazing standalone. Why did pirates wear an eye patch? Do you know the answer? If you don't, then guys, be there at 8 o'clock tomorrow to know what the answer is. It's a very, very, very interesting session. ठीक है, याद रखना कल 8 बजे इस session में जरूर आना. Apart from that, ये weekly schedule है. If you guys want to know, when exactly you have your classes so that you don't miss out on any of the sessions, subscribe right now. I'm waiting. If you are new, subscribe. वो subscribe वाला button है, उसको दबाओ. Bell icon सबसे ज़्यादा important है, guys. Press it so that you get your notification. You do not miss out on any classes. And of course, like the video right now so that I know you are attending. Hi Sarfaraz, hi Ansh, hi Himanshi. Ma'am, please. Yes, of course, I remember you, Avni. All right, so guys, were you there for the Sunday session where me and Haripriya ma'am took the road safety test? Were you there for that? Yes, Priya. Yes, yes, no. What? So guys, on Sunday, remember I told you Sunday we're going to have a lot of fun, and we did have a lot of fun in that session. If you have not seen that video, you totally should, because you will come to know a lot of things about Haripriya ma'am that I revealed. Hi Dev, hi Pratima, hi Sarita. Okay Naman, I will start the class. So guys, before we start, we're going to begin with a very, interesting thought. And that is, when you are kind to others, it not only changes you, it also changes the world. Right? That means that if you have to choose between being right and being kind, always choose being kind. being nice. Even in the chat box, you know, I sometimes look at your comments and I think that the best kids are those who are kind to each other. And of course, more important is being kind to yourself. If you're not doing well in your exams, you know, if you're not reaching your goals, it's okay. It takes time. Be kind to yourself and be kind to others. इस अमेजिंग थॉट से आज का चैप्टर शुरू करते हैं. यस यस रिद्धि मैम आई लाइक टू टेक योर क्लासेस. यस रिद्धि आई विल सून बी स्टार्टिंग माइक्रो कोर्सेज. यू कैन ऑल्सो अटेंड माई माइक्रो कोर्स इफ यू टेक द वेदांत प्रो सब्सक्रिप्शन, बट वो मैं आपको बताऊंगी ठीक है थोड़े टाइम बाद. सो कैन वी स्टार्ट? रेडी? Hearts to you too, guys. If you're giving me a heart, that means you're new to the channel. Welcome to the channel and subscribe. Where do you live? I live in a house. What about you? Living in a cave? Right, yes, Mentee is also there. Poonam, we will try doing that. Don't worry. Okay, so let's quickly start. Thank you, Shubhi, for saying that. Hi, Anushka. Alright, so guys, today as I told you, we are going to start the chapter From Trade to Territory, The Company Establishes Power. We are going to understand how did the British come to India, okay, as traders, how did they eventually establish power, who was this company, East India Company, kaha se aayi? I say it didn't sprout out like mushroom, na? It came from somewhere, right? How did it start trade in Bengal? How did it eventually enter Indian politics? All of this we are going to do in your today's session. So guys, aaj ka session bahut hi zyada important hai. So please apna attention wala hat pehen lo. Theek hai? Pay full attention. Keep your distractions away. Keep your mobile phones away. Mummy, papa, hi bhi bolne aaye. Hi back mat bolna. Bahut important chapter hai. If you understand today's part, you are going to understand your entire class 8. It is very important. Now, before we start, guys, when I started your Young Wonders ka class 8, social studies, I took this video called Class 7 Going to Class 8 Basic Concepts. If you have not watched that video, please watch that video also. Kyunki us video mein main pura samjhati hu ki class 7 ka last chapter kya tha and how we enter your class 8. Very important video. Okay, so if you just go through that, you will easily understand what we are talking about today. Main thoda samjhaungi, but wo wala video bhi dekh lena so that achhi tarah samajh aa jaye. Okay? You are there? Great. Alright, so let's get started. Raman, bachcha, kitna batao? I live in a house. I live in Bangalore. Alright, let's begin. So guys, let's start. So today, as I told you, class 7th standard ka last chapter mein what did we study? We looked at how the Mughal Empire started declining after the death of Aurangzeb in 1707. Aurangzeb was the last powerful Mughal emperor. After he dies, uske baad jo bhi Mughal kings aate hain, jo bhi Mughal emperors aate hain, they are weak. They are not able to hold the entire, territory of the Mughal Empire. So the country starts fragmenting into different parts. Chote chote hisso mein batne lagta hai hamara desh. For example, you have the Marathas, you have Bengal, you have Hyderabad, Awadh. You know, these are the Rajputs. They start asserting their independence, their authority. They start becoming kings of their own regional states. So Delhi is no longer the main center, powerful center. Under the Mughal Empire, jab tak Aurangzeb zinda tha, Delhi bahut important capital tha. Because that is where all the kings sat and they, ruled such a huge territory. But Aurangzeb dies, Mughal Empire declines, there's no longer a strong ruler. We see the emergence of, your small regional states, Rajputs, etc., Marathas, etc. And it is in this scenario, jab hamara country fragmented hota hai, alag alag hisso mein bata hota hai, that we see the entry of East India Company or the British. Okay, this is in the second half of the 18th century. Alright, so that is a little bit of a background as to India kaisa tha before the arrival of the British. This was the scenario. We were fighting amongst each other. We did not have a united front. Alright, okay. Now let's look at what is this East India Company? Where did it come from? Who are they? सो गाइस क्या हुआ था कि इंडिया, इफ यू रिमेम्बर योर सेवेंथ स्टैंडर्ड हिस्ट्री, इंडिया वॉज वेल नोन थ्रू आउट द वर्ल्ड एज सोने की चिड़िया, एज अ गोल्डन बर्ड. यू नो वी वर ऑलरेडी ट्रेडिंग एज गुड क्वालिटी, वेरी फाइन क्वालिटी सिल्क, कॉटन, पेपर. आर गुड्स वर इन ग्रेट डिमांड इन द यूरोपियन मार्केट. तो यूरोप की जो ट्रेडिंग कंपनीज थे, दे वॉन्टेड टू कम टू इंडिया एंड बाय आर गुड्स डायरेक्टली. ठीक है, सो वन सच कंपनी वॉज द, एक सेकेंड, one such company was the East India Company. It was a trading company belonging to Britain. For example, aajkal, you know, we have different companies, Tata Company, Reliance Company. Aise hi, this was a trading company called the East India Company. It belonged to Britain. It wanted to come to India to buy our goods at a very cheap price and sell it in the European market at a very high price. Theek hai? Samajh aa gaya? Now, the East India Company did a very smart thing. In 1600, easy date to remember, right? 1600, it went to Queen Elizabeth II, who was the ruler of Britain, और उन्होंने Queen Elizabeth को बोला कि please हमें permission दे दो कि हम India जाए और वहाँ पर trade करें. Give us a permission, a charter to be the exclusive person to trade with the East. Sole right means exclusively. Give us the right to trade with India, Africa, you know, Asian countries, Indonesia, Malaysia. All of these countries are Eastern countries. Okay? So the East India Company was granted a charter to do it. Now it became the only company from Britain to go to East and to trade. East India Company ne socha, ye to bahut hi mazedar cheez hai, koi competition hi nahi hai. We will go to India, buy goods at 2 rupees, sell it in the European market for 100 rupees. We will be so rich. But that was not true. The problem is, I'm going to come back to that slide. The problem is that when they reached India, they saw that Portuguese had already established their control. Portuguese pehle se Vasco da Gama, a Portuguese explorer, had already discovered the sea route to India. So this is India, theek hai? This is Africa, yaha Britain hai. So Vasco da Gama had already discovered the sea route to India via Cape Town. Theek hai? So Portuguese पहले से वहां थे, Dutch, French पहले से वहां पर थे. East India Company ने बोला ये तो बहुत ज्यादा competition है, इसमें तो हम लोग फंस जाएंगे, right? Now let's understand what were these trading companies. These trading companies were called mercantile trading companies. What is a mercantile trading company? A mercantile trading company is that business enterprise that does not manufacture anything of themselves. वो वाली ट्रेडिंग कंपनीज है जो खुद कुछ बना नहीं रहे. यू नो ईस्ट इंडिया कंपनी, डच ईस्ट इंडिया कंपनी, पोर्चुगीज ईस्ट इंडिया कंपनी, ये खुद कुछ मैन्युफैक्चर नहीं कर रहे थे अपना कॉटन सिल्क. दे वर नॉट मैन्युफैक्चरिंग एनीथिंग. द ओनली थिंग दे वर डूइंग वाज बाइंग समथिंग फ्रॉम इंडिया एट अ लो रेट, टेकिंग इट टू ब्रिटेन एंड सेलिंग इट एट अ हाई रेट. ठीक है, जैसे कबाड़ी वाले नहीं होते, दे टेक न्यूज़पेपर फॉर यू फ्रॉम यू, दे बाय न्यूज़पेपर फ्रॉम यू फॉर 5 rupees एंड देन दे सेल इट टू द अदर एरिया फॉर 20 rupees. So they were kabadiwalas who had come to India to buy our goods, right? And they did so. Okay, that's it. So now the problem was that these are trading companies, Europe se India aa rahe the, and all of them wanted to buy the same things. They wanted to buy our cotton, our silk, our pepper, cloves, cardamom, elaichi, cinnamon, dalchini. They were coming to India to buy these goods from our country. However, प्रॉब्लम इज कि सबको एक ही चीज चाहिए था इंडिया से. ये सारे ट्रेडिंग कंपनीज यूरोप से इंडिया आ रहे थे टू बाय द सेम थिंग. दिस क्रिएटेड कॉम्पिटिशन. तो व्हेन कॉम्पिटिशन यू नो इमर्जेस, प्राइसेस इंक्रीज. फॉर एग्जांपल, एग्जांपल देती हूँ, जब कोविड सिचुएशन शुरू हुआ था, यू नो जब कोरोना वायरस बिकेम दिस थिंग, व्हाट हैपेंड, एवरीवन वांटेड टू बाय अ मास्क, एवरीवन वांटेड टू बाय अ हैंड सैनिटाइजर, है ना? तो जो हैंड सैनिटाइजर 100 rupees का मिलता था, उसका प्राइस 500 rupees हो गया इन द मार्केट, बिकॉज द डिमांड इंक्रीज्ड. सिमिलरली जब ये सब ट्रेडिंग कंपनीज इंडिया आए, एवरीवन वांटेड टू बाय इंडियन गुड्स, दे वांटेड टू बाय आर सिल्क, आर कॉटन. सो द मर्चेंट्स ऑफ इंडिया सेड ओके, देयर आर सो मेनी पीपल हु वांट टू बाय आर कॉटन एंड सिल्क, लेट अस इंक्रीज आवर प्राइसेस. सो अर्लियर दे सोल्ड देयर प्रोडक्ट्स फॉर 10 rupees. Now they started selling the same products for 50 rupees. They said, okay, if you don't want it, someone else will buy it, right? So because the competition increased, Earlier, the cotton they used to buy for 10 rupees, East India Company, and sold it in the European market for 100 rupees. With increasing competition, increase of prices, they had to now buy the same cotton for 50 rupees and they were selling it for 100 rupees. Usse kya problem hua? Ink color change kiya jaye. The profits decreased. Earlier 90 rupees ka profit ho raha tha. Right? Ab sirf 50 rupees ka profit ho raha hai. Profit of the East India Company decreased. Easy? I'm going to revise the entire thing in 2 minutes. Problem kya hua? All of these trading companies from Europe were coming to India to buy the same things. The same cotton, pepper, spices, you know, your silk, etc. Now, because they wanted to buy the same things, demand increase ho gai. Kyunki demand increase ho gai, I told you, jab demand zyada hota hai, to price bhi increase ho jata hai. Agar sabko mera ye cotton t-shirt chahiye, to main 1000 rupees mein bechungi. Right? So, when prices increased, trading companies ka profit gir gaya. पहले वो 90 रुपीस का प्रॉफिट अर्न करते थे, अब वो सिर्फ 50 रुपीस का प्रॉफिट अर्न कर रहे हैं, राइट? सो देयर प्रॉफिट डिक्रीज्ड. तो दिस वाज ऑब्वियसली नॉट लाइक बाय द ट्रेडिंग कंपनीज. इतनी मेहनत करके शिप बना के वो इंडिया आए, उनको तो बहुत सारा प्रॉफिट चाहिए था. दे वांटेड टू अर्न अ लॉट ऑफ प्रॉफिट्स फ्रॉम इंडिया. सो दे स्टार्टेड अटैकिंग ईच अदर. ट्रेडिंग कंपनीज स्टार्टेड अटैकिंग ईच अदर थ्रू आर्म्स. They started blocking each other's, you know, ship routes. They started bombarding each other's ships. Ek dusre ke ships pe bomb fek dete the, jisse unka ship European market pe hi na pahunche. Right? And this is very important. They started fortifying their trading post. Fortifying matlab kila bandi, kile banana, building forts. So in India, guys, again, very important, listen carefully. In India, for example, Britishers yahan hai. They made their trading post here. What is a trading post? It's like a storage house. You know, for they're going all around the country. They are buying goods from Bengal, from Tamil Nadu, from Calcutta, from Gujarat. And they are storing all the products here in the trading post. Kuch din baad ship aata hai. They put it in the ship and they take it to the European market. So these companies started attacking each other's trading posts so that, you know, the goods do not reach the European market. Now, to protect these trading posts, the British East India Company and other, you know, East India companies started fortifying the trading post, started building forts. Jaise, you know, kings used to build forts around their house. So they started building forts around their trading post. Now, is point se local rulers ko problem hone lagi. Obviously, imagine karo, you know, Bengal mein, for example, British East India Company came to Bengal for trade. Bengal Nawabs are happy. They are saying, okay, come trade with us. We are happy. But now they have started building their forts on our land. So Bengal Nawab said, what is this? Good that you're coming to our home, you know, to buy our goods. But how can you build your forts on our land? This is not fair. Hana? So imagine the sabzi wala is coming to your house in your colony and they start building their house in your colony. You will say, what is this? This is not your land. How can you build your house? So this is what created a conflict, a confrontation. You know, aamna saamna ho gaya East India Company and local rulers ka. Theek hai? So this is like the basics you have to understand. Okay, let me see the chat once. Thank you, Teja. So sweet of you. All right. Yes, Riddhi, Queen Elizabeth gave permission to the East India Company. So guys, I hope you got this much. Hai na? Time pe aoge to samajh aa jayega. So can we move on to what happens next? Alright. So, now let's understand what exactly happens when East India Company comes to India. Now, jab East India Company aata hai Bengal mein, it establishes its first factory on the banks of river Hooghly. Hooghly ek beautiful river hai Bengal mein. Wahan par wo apni factory khadi kar deta hai in 1651. Now you're going to say, but ma'am, Britishers were not producing anything. You know, they were buying goods from India, selling it in the European market. Why did they have to establish a factory in India? That's because factory, you know, then is not what we understand today. उस टाइम फैक्ट्री वॉज अ टर्म यूज टू डिफाइन, यू नो, सारे ब्रिटिश ऑफिशियल्स, ईस्ट इंडिया कंपनी के ऑफिशियल्स वहां बैठते थे, दे हैड देयर ट्रेडिंग पोस्ट देयर, देयर स्टोरेज हाउसेस देयर, सो दैट एंटायर एरिया वॉज कॉल्ड अ फैक्ट्री. एंड वहां पर द ऑफिशियल्स हु सैट, यू नो, जो ऑफिसर्स, जो ट्रेडर्स थे, उनको फैक्टर्स बोलते थे, ठीक है, दे वर कॉल्ड फैक्टर्स. ऑलराइट, so all of this entire factory where godown, storage houses, offices were made was established in Bengal in 1651 on the banks of river Hooghly. theek hai, now I told you ki trading post khada kar diya, offices khade kar diye. To protect this, the East India Company started building forts around it. Now agar wo forts banayenge Bengal mein to Bengal nawab ko problem hoga. Bengal nawab said, what is this building fort on my land without my permission? Okay, that is one issue. Second issue that came up was that the East India Company went to Aurangzeb, who was then ruling India. 1696 ki baat hai guys, right? Aurangzeb dies in 1707. So the East India Company, they go to Aurangzeb, aur wo Aurangzeb ko bolte hai ki sir, humko aapke country mein trade karna hai, we want to trade in your country, so please na help us out. Aurangzeb issued a farman. What is a farman? Farman matlab royal order. ठीक है, royal order, an edict, एक order देना, जब king एक order देता है कि East India Company will have the right to trade in India duty free or tax free. That means that East India Company अगर चाहे इंडिया में ट्रेड कर सकता है, इंडिया से चीजें खरीद सकता है बिना टैक्स दिए. Without paying tax, they can trade in India. Very good for the East India Company. But East India Company started manipulating this privilege. ये जो फरमान है, ये पूरे कंपनी को दिया जाता है. So today, अगर गवर्नमेंट बोले कि रिलायंस कंपनी can, you know, if they want, they, you know, they should not pay tax. Company will not pay tax. But the officials who are working in the company, they will have to pay tax na. The farman, the order is only for the entire company. So this is what happened. Aurangzeb gave the farman, the exclusivity to trade in India without paying tax to the entire East India Company. But the officials started doing private trade. So jaise East India Company ki main ek official hu, theek hai? I will go to the market and I will buy 10 kg cotton. I am buying it and I am privately selling it in the European market. But when I am asked to pay tax, I will say I am not paying tax. Aurangzeb gave me a farman. Aurangzeb gave me this right to, you know, do trade duty free. But that was wrong. Aurangzeb gave that right to the company, not to the official. Okay, so they started misusing the privilege. All right, I hope you got this much. Yes? Okay, Yes, Thomas Rowe. ठीक है, so now guys, this created a problem. सारी problems आपको समझ आ गई. Britishers come to India, great. They start trade with our country, और भी अच्छा. We are happy. Our merchants are earning so much money. The problem started when they started building forts around their trading posts. You know, kakila bandi shuru kar dete. They start building their offices, houses. So the Nawabs of Bengal started to say ki, what is this? Why are you building your offices on our land? Second problem is they started misusing the the order given out by Aurangzeb, the farman given out by Aurangzeb. They refused to pay tax to the Bengal. So the Nawabs of Bengal said, this is not fair, right? So when Aurangzeb died in 1707, the entire situation changes. The Nawabs of Bengal said that Aurangzeb is dead, no man powerful, you know, who can rule us. We will be kings of Bengal. So now the Nawab of Bengal, remember this, the first Nawab of Bengal was Murshid Kuli Khan, then you have Ali Wardi Khan, and then you have Siraj ud Daula. Theek hai, Murshid Kuli Khan, Ali Wardi Khan, Siraj ud Daula. All three Nawabs are very strong, very powerful. They do not bow down in front of the British. वो ब्रिटिशर्स को कहते हैं कि देखो औरंगजेब तो मर गया, वी डू नॉट एग्री विद दिस फरमान, नाउ स्टार्ट पेइंग टैक्सेस टू अस, स्टॉप बिल्डिंग योर हाउसेस ऑन आवर लैंड, स्टॉप फोर्टिफिकेशन, स्टॉप बिल्डिंग योर फोर्ट्स, स्टॉप मिंटिंग मनी. ब्रिटिशर्स मनी भी मिंट करने लगे थे, यू नो, कॉइन्स मिंट करने लगे थे. दे सेड स्टॉप मिंटिंग मनी एंड स्टार्ट पेइंग टैक्सेस. ऑलराइट, ठीक है, नवाब्स ने और बोला कि यू नो ईस्ट इंडिया कंपनी इज वेरी डिसरिस्पेक्टफुल, दे नॉट ओनली कम टू इंडिया टू यू नो टू बिल्ड देयर फोर्ट्स बट दे आर आल्सो डिसरिस्पेक्टिंग द नवाब्स इन लेटर्स. सो दे एक्यूज द ईस्ट इंडिया कंपनी ऑफ बीइंग डिसरिस्पेक्टफुल, बदतमीज होने का एक्यूजेशन लगा देते हैं. ईस्ट इंडिया कंपनी ऑब्वियसली चुप नहीं रहेगी, यू नो इट वोंट स्टे क्वाइट. East India Company said that, you know, this is very unfair. We are only a small trading company. Please let us trade in your country without paying tax. Please allow us to build forts. Only then we can earn profit. Okay? But the Nawab said, no, this is not done. Please pay taxes. Please stop your fortification or we will attack you. Now, these two, you know, the arguments were on different sides. So you have the East India Company on one side saying we will not pay taxes. You have the Nawabs of Bengal saying pay taxes, do stop your fortification or else. This confrontation, you know, ultimately leads to the very famous, very popular, very important Battle of Plassey. ठीक है, बहुत ही ज़्यादा मेरा पेन खो गया. बहुत ही ज़्यादा important battle होता है Battle of Plassey because it is this battle that finally allows the entry of British into Indian politics. ठीक है, अभी तक Britishers had no, you know, they did not want to rule India. They only wanted to earn money. But it is this battle that changes the entire face of the East India Company. What is this battle? What happens? This is something we'll do in your next session. ठीक है, but I hope आपको यहाँ तक समझ आ गया कि what was the condition of India before the coming of the British? Who were the East India Company? Why did they come to India? Third part, you understood. When they came to India, when they established, you know, their factory in Bengal, how did that lead to a confrontation with the Nawabs? Ladai jhagda kyo hua? Hamare local rulers se. Theek hai? Ultimately, wo ladai jhagda itna zyada gehra ho gaya that it led to the Battle of Plassey. Alright, in 1757. This is the background of what we studied till now. Guys, I want you ki pura history na aap kahani ki tarah padho, purely story ki tarah padho. Questions kaise likhna hai, answer kaise karna hai, we will do all of that also. For now, just listen to the entire thing like a story. Theek hai? All right. Please explain factory again. So guys, factory is nothing but the area where offices of the traders were. So the people who worked in the offices were called factors. ठीक है, factors. आजकल officers बोलते हैं ना, then they were called factors. वहाँ पर storage houses भी थे where all the goods were stored. So this in trading posts भी थे where goods were you know kept. All of this area was called a factory. कुछ produce नहीं हो रहा था. You know paper, pencil, nothing was being produced here. It was only an area where the officials operated. They had their offices, etc. Right? Robert Clive will do in the next class. All right. So guys, hi Kamarappu. What is Plassey Saatchi? I'll tell you in the next session. Okay. Manan, very easy. Confrontation started because socho na Britishers India mein aaye. Wo trade karne aaye, very good. But they started building forts. They started building their own houses in India. They said, we will not pay tax. Right? They said, thenga hum tax nahi denge. So obviously, our Nawabs got upset. They said, who are these Firangis coming to our land, disrespecting us? This created a problem. Simple. है ना, मुश्किल थोड़ी ना है. कोई आपके घर में आए और आपके घर में ही आपसे बदतमीजी करके अपना, you know, they start living there. What will you do? You will not welcome them, na? You will say, get out of my house. Okay, I cannot be more clearer in my explanation, guys. Okay, so let's go towards the Menti, www.menti.com pe jao. But before we go into that, very important information. My batches are starting. And guys, 8th standard ke 3 batches. 8G, 8H, 8I. All 3 batches are starting this month. So if you want to be in that batch, 7th standard or 6th standard ke bhi batches shuru hai. So if you have your younger siblings or your friends who are in that class, and if you like my teaching or if you like Vedantu, do tell them to join this batch for sure. ठीक है, कैसे join करना है? Very very simple, you know. Now guys, I'm going to just not take a lot of time. जैसे आप video पे जाते हो, ठीक है, मैं छोटंकू जाती हूँ. You, this is my video on resources. अगर नहीं देखा, please देख लो, first chapter of geography. You go down and you will find this link. ठीक है, आप उस लिंक को दबाओगे. क्लास 8 पहले से है. इफ यू आर इन 6th स्टैंडर्ड 7th स्टैंडर्ड दबा दो. आपको ये तीन कोर्सेज मिलेंगे, प्रो लाइट, प्रो क्लासिक, प्रो प्रीमियम। प्रो लाइट मतलब यू विल गेट ऑनलाइन क्लासेस, लाइव क्लासेस जिसमें हम आपस में बात कर सकते हैं, ऑल योर डाउट्स आर सॉल्व ड्यूरिंग द क्लास। यूट्यूब पे तो सॉल्व नहीं कर पाती ना, आई ट्राई टू डू इट बट इट्स नॉट लाइक आई कैन नॉट डू ऑल योर डाउट्स। आपको हर क्लास के बाद टेस्ट मिलते हैं, असाइनमेंट्स मिलते हैं, नोट्स मिलते हैं दैट आर वेरी हेल्पफुल यू नो फॉर योर एग्जाम्स, डाउट्स आर सॉल्व, ये सब चीजें आपको मिलता है प्रो लाइट में, ठीक है। यू कैन ऑल्सो वॉच द रीप्ले, कभी कभी अगर क्लास मिस हो जाए तो यू कैन वॉच द रीप्ले ऑफ द एंटायर सेशन। और रीप्ले बोरिंग नहीं होता यूट्यूब की तरह, आप क्विज भी खेल सकते हो विद यू नो ऑल द स्टूडेंट्स ऑफ द लाइव सेशन। तो आपका नाम लीडर बोर्ड पे भी आता है। सो ऑल ऑफ दिस इज अवेलेबल टू यू इन योर प्रो लाइट। दिस इज द प्राइस फॉर द एंटायर ईयर। ये बहुत ज्यादा लगता है, आई अंडरस्टैंड, मुझे भी बहुत ज्यादा लगता बिकॉज आई वॉज ऑल्सो अ वेरी पुअर स्टूडेंट। सो प्लीज ट्राई इट फॉर वन मंथ, ठीक है। वन मंथ का प्राइस इज वेरी लेस and you get an additional discount if you put in my coupon code SUGPRO, ठीक है। So please put this coupon code SUGPRO और एक महीने के लिए try कर लो, मतलब come to my class, see how it is boring, if it is interesting। अगर यहाँ पर Vedantu students है, you guys can tell the other students how amazing the classes are, you know, हर इतना रगड़ के अच्छी तरह पढ़ा देते हैं ना कि exam में you guys will come, you know, on top, ठीक है। अगर वो नहीं अच्छा लगता तो क्लासिक है where your doubts are solved even after class। So एक additional feature मिल जाता है आपको थोड़ा सा एक्स्ट्रा पैसा में। अगेन ट्राई फॉर वन मंथ इफ यू वॉन्ट इट। नाउ इफ यू आर अ स्टूडेंट जिसको पर्सनल अटेंशन चाहिए होता है कि नहीं मैं तो चाहता हूँ कि मैम बस मुझे ही अच्छी तरह पढ़ाए, तो आप प्रीमियम हमारा पैकेज ले सकते हो विच इज यू नो अगेन 5400। ये थोड़ा महंगा है बिकॉज यू गेट पर्सनल अटेंशन ओनली 15 स्टूडेंट्स इन वन क्लास। सो यू कैन ट्राई दैट आउट ऑल्सो, बट आई वुड से कम फॉर प्रो लाइट, सी हाउ द Vedantu प्लेटफॉर्म इज, इट इज सुपर ऑसम गाइस। मैं ऐसे ही नहीं बोल रही, बहुत मजा आता है, अच्छी तरह पढ़ाई होती है, प्रॉपर आपको कैलेंडर मिलता है, यू कैन वॉच द रीप्ले, यू गेट नोट्स, असाइनमेंट्स एंड इवन आई विल स्टार्ट गिविंग नोट्स। सो ऑल ऑफ दीज थिंग्स आर अवेलेबल टू यू, ठीक है। तो यहाँ पर यू कैन परचेज इट, हाउ टू परचेज, लॉट्स ऑफ वेज यू कैन डू इट, कुछ भी अपना कार्ड, ईएमआई, हाउएवर यू वांट टू पे यू कैन पे। नॉट ओनली सोशल स्टडीज, यू गेट इंग्लिश, मैथ, साइंस एंड जनरल नॉलेज, ठीक है। दीज आर द थिंग्स दैट आर अवेलेबल टू यू। ऑलराइट, सो गाइस ऑफ कोर्स आपको पता ही है इतने अमेजिंग टीचर्स हैं, मुझसे नहीं पढ़ना तो और भी अच्छे टीचर्स हैं हु टीच, सो यू कैन जॉइन देयर बैच आल्सो, बट माय बैचेस आर स्टार्टिंग दिस मंथ। इफ यू वांट टू बी इन माय बैच डू कम गाइस, बहुत मजा आता है। Alright, so that is it for now. Let us go back to Aink, kahan gaya? So guys, aisa type hamara platform hota hai. We have your quizzes, we have the leaderboard. We also have students from all around the world. So these are a few of my students, you know, who I'm talking to. आपको माइक्रो कोर्सेज भी मिलते हैं, सो माइक्रो कोर्सेज लाइक एडिशनल, यू नो अगर वो चैप्टर आपको रिवाइज करना है, वेरी फ्यू स्टूडेंट्स आर देयर इन माइक्रो कोर्सेज, यू कैन डायरेक्टली टॉक टू मी, सो ऑल ऑफ दैट इज आल्सो अवेलेबल। ये फ्रॉम ट्रेड टू टेरिटरी का ही स्लाइड है विच वी टीच ड्यूरिंग क्लास, ठीक है। ओके, सो गाइज वेरी वेरी इंपॉर्टेंट, यूज द कूपन कोड SUGPRO व्हाइल यू आर कमिंग सो दैट यू नो कम टू माई बैच एंड व्हाइल यू आर एंटरिंग Vedantu। नीचे लिंक में, डिस्क्रिप्शन में आपका लिंक मिल जाएगा, दबाओ और आ जाओ एक महीने के लिए, बस। क्यों आओ? क्योंकि मैं प्रॉमिस करती हूँ दैट यू विल इंप्रूव इन योर एग्जाम। इफ यू वर अ 70% स्टूडेंट तो आप 90% स्टूडेंट बन जाओगे। तो यू नो अगर आप नहीं बनते, इफ यू फील कि नहीं मैम पैसा वेस्ट हो गया, पानी में चला गया, कोई फायदा ही नहीं हुआ, तो आई विल गिव यू ऑल दैट मनी बैक। Vedantu प्रॉमिसेस दैट ऑल दैट मनी बैक विल बी गिवन टू यू, ठीक है। बट ऑफकोर्स 75% क्लासेस में आना पड़ेगा, ठीक है, एंड आपको थोड़े बहुत असाइनमेंट्स करने होंगे, एंड वी एश्योर यू दैट यू विल सी एन इम्प्रूवमेंट, ठीक है। स्पेशली फॉर योर पेरेंट्स गाइज, दिस इज स्पेशली फॉर योर पेरेंट्स हु माइट थिंक कि हम क्यों अपने बच्चे को उसमें डालें। ऑलराइट, ठीक है, सिंपल कूपन कोड SUGPRO को यूज करो एंड प्लीज मेरे बैच में आओ, तो देखो जस्ट फॉर वन मंथ यू कैन सी हाउ द बैच फील्स लाइक। Alright, so let's go to Riddhi soon, soon. Dakshesh, happy birthday. Hi, Purva. Okay, so guys, go to menti.com. Please type in the code 158316888 to join the Menti. Or koi question, anything you want to ask about the batch or how to join, you can totally do that. Renu, yes, I said Elizabeth 1, right? I think. Queen Elizabeth 1. Yes, Aryan, this is the second chapter of history. All right, yes, I will give homework also, Krishna. Who were the Nawab of Bengal? Raman. First it was Murshid Kuli Khan, then Ali Wardi Khan, then Siraj ud Daula. Important because it could come in menti. Yes. Guys, I will also be making a video soon as to how you can use these online classes to make notes. So don't worry about that. Thank you, Mudrika. All right, so let's go. My Instagram ID. Good question. So guys, it is Surabhi, Surabhi dot Vedantu. Okay, you can follow me there if you want. If you don't want, it's okay. Don't follow. All right, so let me be Chutanku. And let me refresh the page. Yes. Khushi homework denge. I will give you homework. Don't worry. You guys are such nice kids. Na, ma'am, homework de do. Prashant, really? Guys, I mean personally, I love the platform. काश अगर मैं student होती, अगर मेरे पास कुछ ऐसा होता कि घर बैठे ही, you know, I get assignments also, tests also, classes also, I would have joined. But मर्जी है. Of course, no one is forcing you. If you guys think that this will help you should join. Right. Great, Nisha. I hope I helped. So guys, अभी ना बहुत सारे बच्चे वॉच कर रहे हैं बट बहुत कम लाइक्स है. गिव मी अ लाइक ओनली देन आई विल स्टार्ट. एंड इफ यू आर न्यू टू द चैनल सब्सक्राइब राइट नाउ सो दैट यू डू नॉट मिस ऑन एनी क्लास क्विकली. आ थैंक यू अजन. नो आई एम नॉट फ्रॉम महाराष्ट्र, आई एम फ्रॉम दिल्ली. कैन वी स्टार्ट? यस क्विकली आ जाओ जल्दी से. लेट मी जस्ट रिफ्रेश वंस मोर बिकॉज आई कैन सी लेस स्टूडेंट्स. थैंक यू आशिक. ऑल राइट अदिति. हु वाज़ द किंग आफ्टर औरंगजेब? वेरी गुड क्वेश्चन अंगिरा. गाइस इट वाज़ हिज नेम. ओके यू नो व्हाट, दिस इज आवर वन फर्स्ट होमवर्क क्वेश्चन. ठीक है, वो एक्स्ट्रा एफर्ट वाला मेडल चाहिए ना, सो यू विल पुट दिस इन द कमेंट सेक्शन. हु वाज़ द किंग आफ्टर औरंगजेब एंड व्हाट वाज़ ही पॉपुलरली नोन एज? उसका He had one name, but he was popularly known as something else. All right, so let's quickly begin. The first question of the mentee is in front of you. No, first we'll wait for all the players. ठीक है, सब आ गए. मछली आ गई, सांप आ गया, लायन आ गया, खरबूजा आ गया, तरबूज आ गया. ग्रेट ग्रेट. थैंक यू कृष्णा फॉर सेइंग दैट. इट्स ओके. All right, so let's start with the first question of the day. Who was the Nawab of Bengal after the death of Ali Wardi Khan? Mir Qasim, Siraj ud Daula, Murshid Kuli Khan, or Manmohan Singh? Who was the Nawab of Bengal after the death of Ali Wardi Khan? बच्चा संगीता मेंटी कोड इज 1583 1688. ऊपर दिख रहा होगा ना छोटा सा. Are you sure? But guys, it could also be Manmohan Singh, no? Time is up. Four people have said Manmohan Singh. बच्चा क्या बोलूं मैं आपका? क्या बोलूं? नहीं, the answer is Siraj ud Daula. First it's Murshid Kuli Khan, then you have Ali Wardi Khan, then Siraj ud Daula. और भी थे बीच में, but these are the famous and very important nawabs who stood up against the Britishers and said, you cannot come into my country and build your house. Get out. ठीक है, और पे टैक्सेस. सो दीज वर द इम्पोर्टेंट स्ट्रॉन्ग नवाब्स दैट यू हैव टू रिमेम्बर. ऑल राइट, लीडर बोर्ड देखा जाए. जसवंत प्लीज रिप्लाई ऑन टेली. गाइस टेलीग्राम में आई एम नॉट वेरी एक्टिव क्योंकि पूरा दिन बहुत काम होता है. सो आई डोंट गेट टाइम. सो वी हैव कृष्णा वर्मा ऑन टॉप, देन वी हैव निष्ठा, विनीत, चार्वी, आराधना, श्रीजा, जसवंत, आदित्य, आर्यन एंड सौम्या ऑन टॉप ऑफ द लीडर बोर्ड. गुड जॉब. Question 2 of question 5 is who discovered this sea route to India in 1498? Vasco da Gama, Albert Einstein, Queen Elizabeth, or none of these? This sea route from Europe to India. वेरी इंपॉर्टेंट सी रूट क्योंकि इससे पहले ना ट्रेड यूज टू हैपन थ्रू द रेड सी. सेवन स्टैंडर्ड हिस्ट्री याद है? भूल गए. थ्रू द रेड सी, थ्रू द मिडिल ईस्ट ट्रेड होता था. सिल्क रूट के थ्रू ट्रेड होता था. बट इस सी रूट के डिस्कवरी के बाद दे वुड कम बाय शिप्स एंड डायरेक्टली कम टू आर कंट्री. टाइम इज अप. पीपल हु सेड अल्बर्ट आइंस्टाइन. क्या हो रहा है गाइस, क्या हो रहा है? अल्बर्ट आइंस्टाइन वाज अ साइंटिस्ट. ही डिडंट हैव टाइम टू डिस्कवर सी रूट्स. इट वाज वास्को द गामा हु डिस्कवर्ड दैट सी रूट एंड एस्टैब्लिश्ड देयर पोर्चुगीज हेडक्वार्टर्स इन गोवा. ऑलराइट, लेट्स लुक एट द लीडर बोर्ड. कृष्णा वर्मा स्टिल ऑन टॉप बट हिमांशु वाज द फास्टेस्ट. वी हैव निष्ठा श्रीजा बिनीत आनंदी श्रीजन चार्वी आर्यन एंड सौम्या. यस सुंदर सर डिस्कवर दैट रूट. हाँ सुंदर सर कैन डू इट. ही कैन टोटली डू इट. क्वेश्चन थ्री ऑफ क्वेश्चन फाइव इज इन फ्रंट ऑफ यू. व्हेन डिड औरंगजेब डाई? ईयर बहुत इंपॉर्टेंट ईयर है. आई हैव सेड इट 1000 टाइम्स. 1700, 1707, 1705, 1708. जगरीति हैप्पी बर्थडे. मिसक्लिक हो गया स्नेहा. इट्स ओके, इट्स ओके. होता है, होता है. कम ऑन गाइस क्विकली. रितु आर यू श्योर? गाइस इट्स अ वेरी इजी डेट टू रिमेंबर क्योंकि इसमें से एक नंबर रिपीट होता है. 1707 तो 7 इज गेटिंग रिपीटेड है ना. तो 1707 औरंगजेब डाइज. और रिमेंबर दिस लाइक अभी से ही रट लो. व्हेन औरंगजेब डाइज देन द मुगल एम्पायर स्टार्ट्स डिक्लाइनिंग. Alright, who is on top of the leaderboard? We have Nishtha on top, then we have Charvi, Bineet, Srijan, Sachi, Krishna Verma, Sejal, Aradhna, Saksham, who's someone from class 7, but she wants to study class 8, and Shivangi on top of the leaderboard. Good job, guys. He died by getting infected from COVID. Ha! No. So guys, Aurangzeb actually dies at a very old age, and you know, his lifelong aim was to defeat the Marathas. You know, if you've studied 7th standard with me, then you know the entire story. It's a very interesting story. All right, the next question is, the first English factory was set up on the banks of which river? Ganga, Yamuna, Hooghly, Indus. I'll give you a hint. Guys, Bengal mein sabse pehli factory established hui thi in Bengal. So which river are we talking about? Are you sure? Indus, wow. Guys, geography bhi padhaungi main. Where is Indus? Where is Bengal? Saksham, kuch bhi. Time is up. The fastest fingers list, sorry. Fastest fingers is in the Vedantu app. We have Hooghly as the correct answer. And let's look at the leaderboard. Krishna Verma bachcha niche chala gaya. But right now on top is Nishtha, Charvi, Krishna Verma, Sachi, Shivangi, who's fastest, Sejal, Bineet, Srijan, Saksham, and Adarsh, who says he will win. But right now he's at the bottom. Final question. Theek hai, final question of the day is in front of you. Let us see. Guys, important question hai. Sun lo. What does the word Farman mean? Aurangzeb gave out a Farman. Royal order, royal dress, royal procession, or royal food. Aurangzeb gave out a farman saying that the East India Company can trade in India duty free without paying taxes. Remember? What is mercantile? Ritu, mercantile matlab wo wali business companies, wo wala enterprise jo ek country se, you know, low price pe kuch kharita hai aur kahin aur high price pe bechta hai. Theek hai? So that's what the East India Company did. Yes, the answer is royal order. Guys, I even gave you an example. Aurangzeb gave this farman. Aurangzeb didn't give East India Company a royal dress to wear or royal food to eat. Theek hai? Kya? Kuch bhi. Alright, let's look at the final leaderboard of the day and see who is the winner. Is Adarsh gonna win? Can he? No. We have Nishtha who is on top. So guys, Talia, Talia, don't be jealous of her. Give her an applause. Congratulations, Nishtha, to be on top of the leaderboard. Now, before we go, guys, aaj ka homework aapke saamne ye raha. What attracted the European trading companies to India? Why did the European trading companies come to India? To buy what? Okay, this is the question for the day. फॉर टॉप फाइव पीपल जो कमेंट सेक्शन में लिखते हैं उनका नाम आएगा, रैंडम फाइव पीपल यू नो हु गिव देयर आंसर्स बिफोर 2 o'clock टुमारो, आई विल पुट देयर नेम्स एंड वन एक्स्ट्रा एफर्ट मेडल, जिन्होंने पूरा वीडियो देखा है दे विल नो व्हाट दैट एक्स्ट्रा क्वेश्चन इज. सो गाइस दैट्स इट फॉर टुडे. ऑलराइट सो गाइस दैट्स इट फॉर टुडे. आई विल बी सीइंग यू इन द नेक्स्ट क्लास टुमारो. No, not tomorrow. On Wednesday at 2 o'clock. Tomorrow, 8 o'clock. Be there for this amazing session to know why did pirates wear an eye patch. And agar aapko mere batch mein aana hai Vedantu mein, do remember to click on the link in the description and enter the coupon code SUGPRO to get dhamakedar discount. This is your master teacher, Surabhi ma'am, signing out. Bye-bye. Have a great day.